A simple question. What skills are sought after the most by the recruiters, HR, or the employer? I think based out of our research and experience, you would definitely say the most sought after, which we have listed down, top 10 skills by the recruiters, HR, or employers most interested in. The first one is teamwork. Remember, show, don't tell. Write something like collaborated with colleagues on a complex project to organize resources and enable the delivery of the project on time and within budget when it comes to writing your CV or resume. The second would be customer service. Every business deals with customers at some point. Depending on your role, you may work in a customer-facing capacity or behind the scenes. Think about the ways that you have dealt with customers in the past. If you have successfully resolved a difficult situation, include this in your CV. Time management, number three. Employers like to see that you can manage your time effectively. Productive and efficient staff are more valuable to the business. Demonstrate how you manage your time to deliver a project or an assignment before the deadline. Number four, leadership. Was there an occasion where you led a team and achieved great success, or coordinated a student project and obtained a high mark for your contribution as a leader? Make sure that you include this in your CV or resume. Number fifth, communication. As one of the most highly rated skills in the workplace, communication is crucial, whether it is written or verbal. You will be expected to communicate effectively with colleagues, customers, and partners. If you can select an example which shows how you use your communication skills to influence or persuade an individual or group, rather than simply saying that you possess excellent communication skills, will be of more relevance. Number six, problem solving. This is another important skill that you need to demonstrate. Think of a situation when you use logic and reasoning to reach a suitable solution, conclusion, or approach. Number seven, creativity. In an environment where businesses are becoming increasingly competitive, demonstrating your ability to think outside the box is becoming more and more important. Have you thought of a new idea, created a new way of working, or managed a creative campaign? Try and mention it in your CV or resume. Flexibility. Things change quickly in the modern workplace, from tools and technologies to systems and processes. Everything changes. Being receptive to change and being able to adapt to new situations and environments is very pertinent. Industry specific skills, number nine. There are certain skills that are essential in certain industries. In finance and accounting, for example, the ability to create financial reports is an important skill, as are skills in forecasting, making projections, and completing audits. Don't assume that your potential employer will know that you possess these skills. If you have them, make sure they are included in your resume or CV. Number 10, digital skills. Many businesses now operate online, but there is a huge shortage of digital skills. If you can demonstrate skills such as managing WordPress, G Suite, Microsoft, Excel, blogging, managing online communities, add them very well in your CV or resume. How to choose the right balance of skills? Now that you understand what kinds of skills are important and the difference between technical and soft skills, it's time to look at how you can incorporate them into your CV. You can't list every single skill that you have, so you will have to be strategic in selecting the most suitable ones for the role you are applying for. And how will you do it? Just reading and understanding the job description. The best way to approach this is to underline or highlight all the skills that the recruiter has specifically mentioned in the job specification or job description. Let's say, by way of example, that you were looking for a marketing manager role and you have come across a job description that outlines the following duties and responsibilities: manage and implement digital marketing campaigns, oversee the social media strategy, lead a team of in-house and freelance team members, manage and maintain the company's CMS, maintain search engine optimization strategies for the company's website, work in partnership with experts and agencies, organize and attend company events, act as the main point of contact for marketing, or manage the CRM system. Let's now know a little closer at the types of skill that the recruiter is looking for. Soft skills: lead a team of freelancers, so leadership skills. Act as the main point of contact for marketing, communication, work in partnership with experts and agencies, teamwork. And what could be the technical skills asked in the job description? Manage and maintain the company's CMS system, so content management systems. Maintain SEO strategies, so search engine optimization would be the keyword. Manage the CMS, example WordPress or G Suite or Microsoft Excel. As you go through the list, you should be confident that you can demonstrate most, if not all, of the skills. If you are struggling to think of an occasion when you carried out a similar responsibility, consider how critical that skill appears. If it's a must-have, you may not be an appropriate fit for that role. Weaving skills into your CV is an art and skill both. Now, it's a time to craft your CV around the skills you have highlighted, using strong examples either through your experience, education, or training. Make sure that you can provide evidence of each of the skills and make them achievements focused and quantitative. So rather than saying accountable for CEO strategies, say managed and CEO strategy, which delivered a 50% increase in organic traffic to a client's website and boosted sales by 20%. The second example not only shows that you have a technical skill, it demonstrates how you have used that skill and achieved positive results. Another tip is to make use of LinkedIn to find out the skill sets of professionals who already hold a similar job title to the opportunity you are applying for. Add any skills that you think are good fit for your CV or resume. You can also include a key skill summary in your CV, making it a prominent section at the side or top. Your skills should capture the attention of the person reading your CV. That being said, don't just reserve your skills for a short section. They should be sprinkled throughout, including the section on your experience and voluntary work, as well as the professional summary at the beginning. So final thoughts to this is, to conclude, a skills-based CV is critical in today's job market. To have the best chances of success, you should write a strong professional summary, ensuring that your most important skills are highlighted. Include a distinct skill section in your CV, ideally at the side or the top of the document. Order your skills from strongest to weakest, or in order of importance or relevance to the job that you are applying for. Review the job description and identify hard and soft skills. Match the skills in the job description to your own skill set. Quantify your skills using hard numbers and make them as achievements focused as possible. If you do include statistics, make sure that they are truthful and they can be validated if checked. Break your skills down into clear and concise bullet points. Ultimately, a skills-based CV should provide recruiters with the confidence that you possess the right knowledge and experience to excel as an employee to their organization. So by stating all these important skill sets, 10 important skill sets that we have just laid down, now it becomes very pertinent and important for us to know and go through the job description. If we have gone through job description thoroughly, try and identify which are the skill sets which are mentioned there, which are the skill sets that you possess. And if you can map them down and write it in a keyword, that would attract not only the HR within the 20 seconds that he takes time to go through your resume or CV and immediately call you. So essentially, you should take a note of all these 10 skills, and if you possess them and if it matches the job description, I think it's worth considering. Be ready with an example so that nothing is hidden, nothing is fake, everything is meaningful, logical, and scientific. So I hope you all will take a note of this and prepare your CV and resume considering these top skills, top 10 skills that recruiters are mostly interested in. Here's wishing you all best luck. Thank you.